done an excellent job. I do have one question that I'd like to ask. I saw Ms. Wilson look at you, so I know it's 8:25. QE on a number of occasions told the general public that the city is not offering early college academy effective, and not also high school, the international baccalaureate program will remain after consolidation of the systems. The VECA program was a great sponsor program that has ended or will end shortly. Will the Lowndes Board of Education continue to fund these programs with local funds? IB at Dallas High School is expensive, and will these programs continue at this level at Dallas High School?
I can't possibly answer that question right now. I think that, as I said, Sam, there will be winners and losers. I think I do agree that those programs are a very good program. I'm a strong proponent of the IB program. I was responsible for helping to bring the IB program to Central High School in Macon, Georgia. We were the second IB high school in the state of Georgia. And I believe in the program, but the problem comes down to finances. Can we afford to offer these programs? There are a lot of good programs at Lowndes. There are a lot of good programs in the Valdosta City School System. But when I talk about the complicated issue and the complexities of this issue, it's sitting down and determining, well, which programs do we keep? And it's probably going to come down to the performance of those programs, but more so, how much those programs cost and can we afford it? I honestly think that that both systems will have to give up some of the things that they're currently doing, because as I said, we can't continue to do everything that we're currently doing. We're going to have to make some choices, and that's going to be a very difficult decision. And that's, if consolidation were to occur, it's going to be a decision that Lowndes County School Board is going to have to make.
And if you would allow me, just one more question.
Okay.
What will happen to the Education Special Local Purpose Option Sales Tax, ESPLOST, that was voted on in March by the city and county residents on specific projects if consolidation occurs, which is $169 million economic impact on our community?
That's a question I'm going to defer to our attorney, because he's met with the state tax people regarding that matter.
Gary Mosher, the attorney for the city school system, and I met with the state tax commissioner's office and the state attorney general's office as it relates to SPLOST 3 and 4. The existing SPLOST, what happens, and if when the new SPLOST takes effect. To answer your question is, this is a consistent theme that I'm going to have, we don't know. It's never happened before. What would normally take place if the city school system and the county school system got together and decided it was in the best interest of our community to try to merge the school systems, we would form that in our SPLOST ballot questions and properly identify the locations that were going to be built or improved. If consolidation occurs, there is no such thing as the Valdosta City School System from the date that it is approved by the Secretary of State. So once they certify the election, there is no central office of the Valdosta City School System. There is a property located on William Street that is part of the Lowndes County School System. So the identity of some of those specific locations will really not apply. So the real question is, where would the funds designated for those facilities go, and can you even spend it? Tax Commissioner doesn't know, Attorney General doesn't know, and we don't know.
Huey probably knows.